Okay, so the first progression or exercise that you need to be able to do well is a front squat. So it's an exercise, we were just discussing it a second ago. Nobody does front squats really. And I don't know why, like, what's your thoughts on that?
I don't know. I think there's quite a lot of focus, like in the media and things like that, on back squats, especially around women.
Yeah.
But front squats just seems to be one of those alien exercises that no one ever thinks of.
Yeah.
Why do front squat? You can do a back squat.
Yeah. But well, that's probably it. They do.
Body, so.
Yeah. They work different areas and they're good for different things.
Yeah.
And front squats, we always do front squats for a significant amount of time before we do back squats. And it helps for your posture, helps to train you in a good squat pattern, and then a back squat is all the easier for that. But people jump to back squats, I think, probably because they can put more weight on, and it's an ego thing. It's like, you can probably do 20-30% more on a back squat than a front squat, so I want the 20-30% more.
Yeah.
But it's not conducive to great movement.
People
so, yeah.
Flexibility of the shoulders.
Yeah, they complain, it's, yeah. They're soft, it's all good.
Yeah.
Anyway, so let's do front squats. So, key thing of the front squat is that the bar is really across the shoulders here. It's not about holding it on your hands or your wrists. So, if you complain of wrist pain, it's because you're not giving enough weight on the shoulders. And everything else is fairly straightforward. So, nice wide stance, toes pointed out, kind of 5-1, 10-2. You could go a little bit wider if you want there, so go half a board wider with your heels. Your heels, yep, that's it. And just do 4 or 5 reps, nice and easy. And we're going to try and keep the elbows up all the time. That's it, nice and high with your elbows. Okay, so front squats, there's a lot more we can do on that, and that's a topic for another day. We'll do that on a different episode. But we're just going to take you quickly through a progression to get you to be able to do the power clean with good technique, certainly the hand clean. So the front squat's the first one. Second one is a stiff leg deadlift. So big exercise, really important for your repertoire, your toolbox as an athlete, as a coach, to be able to teach and coach and execute the stiff leg deadlift. So you're going to pick up the bar, you're going to hold it at waist height. You're going to go toes forward on this one from here. You're going to do a slight bend in the knee, and then chest out, shoulders back. And then all you're gonna do, Sophie, is push your bum backwards and upwards. Think about pushing it into the top corner of the room. And we wanna get that nice flat back. Go for it. Good. That's it, just go to sort of mid-shin, and then really nice flat back here. And just pause at the bottom of the set. So we've got that position where it's just above vertical, it's not too low, so it's mid-shin or so. Really good hamstring work. And then the driving of the hips through at the top, bang, really right through. That's great. One more, and try and always use that cue, hump the bar at the top. You push your hips through and hump it. Time, good. And rest there. So that's the second exercise in the clean progression. The third one we're going to do today is a pull to catch.
Yep.
So you're going to start with the bar here. You're going to pull it up your body. And at that point where you would have no choice but to rotate your hands out, you're going to drop underneath the bar and you're going to catch it in that front squat position. So it'll be somewhere around about halfway down the front squat there.
Yep.
Okay, have a go with that one. So head up, chest up, pull it up and then drop. That's it. Good. And then no jumping forwards. So you want to think about jumping backwards. Good. Good. And just hold it at your waist sec. So what we're looking for with this one is, it's the speed under the bar. So from here, the speed into that position. And then that's going to help you with your clean. So really get that speed on that jumping down, as we call it. Good. Good. The most important part that people get wrong now on the clean is this, what we call the hit, bang, that contact point where you hit the bar with your thighs. So we're going to isolate that. Take the bar out, say a centimetre from your thighs, and then just take your thighs to it and give it a good bang. Just let it come wherever it goes. Don't think about that. Think about the contact point. Okay. Good. And again. Good. Just give it a big bang. Always trying to rattle the collars here, get those moving. Good. Couple more. Good. One more. That's it. And time. And time. And don't fall forward now. That was just, you were just showing people how to not do it there with that last one. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's right. So let's, whereabouts is that contact point? Just,
right there.
It's right there. And that's in a good position. Yeah, you can just about see it. So when you, the thighs need to contact the bar in the middle third. Okay, so it shouldn't be right up in the groove, and it shouldn't be right down at the bottom of the thigh. It should be somewhere here. And that's dependent on your limb length, your body positions, your biomechanics. So yep. I'm happy with that because it's in the middle, it's in that third in the middle. So the hit is key. Okay, if you're not getting that, you're not getting the power that you need to get from this lift. It's not going to work for you in that way. So we isolate that before we put it back into the main movement. So we've got that. And now we're going to work on a stiff leg deadlift to hit. Okay, so you're going to do a stiff leg here, and then you're going to come back through and hit. Good. So nice stiff leg deadlift just below the knee. Good. And get a big hit and stay over the bar. Good. Lovely. That's a better one. Two or three more. Good. Nice sound. You get the feedback from the bar. Good. And again, one more. One more for luck. Good. And time. So we've done the hit. I've isolated that. Then the stiff leg deadlift to the hit, we've isolated that. We've done the pull to catch, we've isolated that. And don't forget, all of these things, you can actually train them and do, practice them and do three or four sets of each one of these things to refine them and groove that technique. Now we're gonna do what's called a hang clean, okay? So basically it's a combination. It's a stiff leg deadlift to the hit, to the catch. So a stiff leg deadlift to a hit, to a catch. Good.
It's hard with the bar tonight.
It is, yeah. You need some weight on, don't you? Good. So think about jumping backwards for you, Sophie. This is a personal cue to Sophie. She always jumps forward, goes horizontally. So we want to jump backwards and take that away. Good, good. And again. Jump backwards. Better. Even more, though. That's it. So we've basically gone right the way from front squats down to a hang clean now. And these are all things that you can train. Hang clean's a great movement. A lot of the time, if you're, there's a strong argument to say that a lot of people never really need to do full cleans. They only need to do hang cleans because the power clean and the Olympic lifts in general, it's about that component there. It's about that triple extension, that power. I don't subscribe to that as much because I think it's a great skill, a great tool to have in the box. But certainly what we've done today, if you're a rugby player, if you're a team sport athlete, if you haven't got a lot of time and you want to just work on a couple of sessions a week to include the Olympic lifts, it's not a bad idea to start to nail that hang clean. And you can weight that up and you get some really good weight on it. A lot of people can actually lift more on a hang clean than they can on a full clean. And it's just because they train it in that way. So you can get some serious power on this. But we're going to take it down to the floor now. We're going to work on the start position and then coordinating it up.